हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मोशन इन वन डायमेंशन, अर्थात दैट इज मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन। टाइप ऑफ मोशन, फर्स्ट यूनिफॉर्म मोशन इन दिस केस, वेलोसिटी कांस्टेंट, यूनिफॉर्म एक्सेलरेशन मोशन इन दिस केस ड्यूरिंग द मोशन, एक्सेलरेशन इज कांस्टेंट एंड वेरिएबल एक्सेलरेशन इन दिस केस, एक्सेलरेशन इज चेंजेस। हियर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरिएबल एक्सेलरेशन, वी नो दैट वी इज इक्वल टू डीएस बाई डीटी, एक्सेलरेशन ए इज इक्वल टू डीवी बाई डीटी एंड ए इज इक्वल टू ए कैन बी रिटन एज वी डीवी बाई डीएफ, दिस कैन बी रिटन एज दिस कैन बी रिटन एज डीएस इज इक्वल टू वी डीटी, दिस कैन बी रिटन एज डीएस इज इक्वल टू वी डीटी, दिस कैन बी रिटन एज डीवी इक्वल टू ए डी टी एंड दिस कैन बी रिटन एज एंड ए वी डी वी इक्वल टू ए डी एफ। हियर दिस हियर इंटीग्रेटेड, हियर इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी एस इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वी डी टी, हियर इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ VDT, this can be written as integration of integrated dV equal to integration of ADT and in this case GDV, integration of VDV equal to integration of ADX, integration of ADX. Now uniform acceleration, यूनिफॉर्म एक्सेलरेशन ए इज ए कांस्टेंट, ए इज कांस्टेंट ड्यूरिंग द मोशन, सो दैट इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डीवी इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ ए डी टी। In this case, we take the limit dv, and initial velocity u to final velocity v, and this is integrated with respect to t, t is equal to 0 to final t. In this case, now integration of dv equal to v limit u, integration of v is equal to this v and limit will be u to v equal to a 1 dt, integration of 1 dt is equal to t and this is varying from 0 to t here. Now this can be written as putting this v minus u equal to a and putting t is equal to t and t equal to 0, one simple t, so that this can be written as v equal to u plus a t. This is the equation of motion. This v is equal to u plus a t. This is the first equation of uniform acceleration. This is the first equation of uniform acceleration, uniformly acceleration, this is uniformly acceleration. Now we see in this case ds, now by first here integration of dv is equal to a dt. Integration of by first integration of ds is equal to integration of v dt. We take the limit the initial point to distance between initial point to final point 0 to s ds is equal to time 0 to t, so that 1 dx is equal to s and v is equal to u plus 18, putting here u plus 18, so that the u of integration 0 to t u 1 dt plus a comes out, because a is a constant, and integration of t dt, so that u 1 dt integration of 1 dt to t and limit 0 to t, so that its value will be simple t here a, and x to power m is equal to x to power m plus 1 divided by 2, so that integration of t to power t dt and t to power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 t square by 2, so that x is equal to ut plus half a t square. This is the second equation of motion. Now by the third here, third integration of v dv by integration of a ds, here a is equal to v dv by ds, so that integration of v dv by integration of a ds, v dv equal to integration of a ds, taking limit v, v is the velocity and its initial to final velocity, limit will be u to v, v dv equal to s, distance s, so that v to power v dv and v to power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1, so that v square by 2, lower limit u and upper limit v is equal to a, and 1 dx, that integration is s, so that simply s, as, and putting the upper limit v is equal to v and v is equal to u, v is equal to v square by 2 minus u square by 2, this can be written as v square minus u square by 2 equal to as, this comes here 2 as, so that v square by u square plus 2 as. This is the third equation of motion. Now we take some Now here question number 1, a equal to 2t, it means that acceleration a is the function of t, then find a velocity v at t is equal to 2 second, second displacement from 0 to 2 second, solution of 1. Solution of 1, here we know that a is equal to dv by dt, a equal to, here in this a equal to dv by dt, so that now given that a is equal to 2t, this can be written as dv equal to a dt, and a equal to 2t, putting this dv 2t and dt, integrating this dv equal to integration of 2t dt here, so that dv by dt, now that this is v is equal to 0 to v, and the time t is equal to 0 to t here, so that integration of dv is equal to simple v, and this is 2 into t square by 2, t square by integration of t, t to power n plus 1 by n plus 1, and t to power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1, 2 to cancel, so that v equal to t square. Now find v at t is equal to 0, and velocity equal to, putting t equal to 2 second, so that velocity v at 2 seconds equal to t square and 2^4 meter per second. This is the velocity of the particle. Now for the second here we have to calculate the displacement from this so that the now here for the second displacement from 0 to 2 second here v is a function of t square, v is a function of t square. As you know that velocity ds by dt is equal to v, so that ds by dt into t square, and so that ds is equal to t square dt. Now taking the limit ds and 0 to s and time 0 to t, so that integration of 0 to s ds and 0 to t t square dt, here 1 ds is equal to only s, so putting s is equal to s and 0, s minus 0, this is equal to, as we know that integration of x to the power n dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. In the similar things, t to the power t plus t to the power n, n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, t to the power 2 and t to the power 2 plus 1 and 3 divided by 2 plus 1, 3, so that s is here, and putting t cube by 3 here, and displacement at 0 to 2 second t equal to 2, so that displacement will be t equal to 2 to the power 3 by 3, 2 to the 4 to the 8 by 3 meter per second here. Now question number 2, if x equal to t cube plus 2x square plus 5 and x is a function of time, then find the function average velocity from t equal to 1 to t equal to 3 seconds. Second, find the average acceleration from 1 second t equal to 1 to 3 seconds. Now here displacement x is the function of time, x is equal to t cube plus 2x square plus 5. As you know that average velocity is equal to the final velocity in x3, displacement at the after the time t second, 3 second, subtract this 3 second and minus 1 second, t3 minus t1, so that displacement at the time t is equal to 3, putting t is equal to 3 because this is the function of t, so that 3 to the power 3 plus 2 into 3 to the power 2 plus 5, 3 to 3 is 9, 3 is 27, 3 to 3 is 9, 2 is 18, and 5, this is equal to 50 meters here, 50 meters, and displacement at time t1, putting t is equal to 1, in this case, 1, this is a 2, this is a 5, this is 8 meters. So that the average velocity is equal to x3 minus x1 here, 50 minus 8 by 3 minus 1, this is a 42 by 2, 21 meter per second. This is the answer of the first average velocity. Now find the average acceleration in this case. We know that average acceleration is equal to v3 minus v1 divided by t3 minus t1. Here, as we know that v can be written as dx by dt, displacement with respect to time is known as velocity, so that v can be written as dx by dt. A s is the function of t here, putting the value of x, t cube plus 2 t square plus 5, differentiate it with respect to time, nx n minus 1, d by d of x to the power n equal to nx n minus 1, this is the differential formula. We differentiate here 3 t to the power 3 minus 1 in 3 t square. This is the 2 to the 4 t, and constant term its differentiation is 0. Now dt is the function of 3 t square plus 4 t t, function of the time t. Now we find the v3, putting the t is equal to 3 in this function, we get v3 is equal to 39 meter per second, and v1 velocity after 1 second, that is v1, putting t equal to 1 in this case, this is equal to 7 meter per second. Now we have get to average acceleration t is equal to 1 to t is equal to 3. As you know that rate of change of velocity with respect to time, that is known as acceleration. So that v3 minus v1, 39 minus 7 divided by t3 minus t1 and 3 minus 1, that is 32 by 2 and 16 meter per second square. This is the average acceleration. The question number 3. Here question number 3, acceleration is the function of velocity or a equal to minus kb. Kb, acceleration is opposite to the velocity because here negative sign, and the initial velocity is v0, then so that velocity is function of time, I will add velocity is the function of distance. Now given that a, we know that acceleration a is equal to dv by dt and a is a minus k dv, so that dv by v is equal to minus k dt here, and taking integration here, this limit is initial velocity to final velocity. If v0 is initial velocity and v is the final velocity, and time, this is the integration with respect to time, it will be t equal to 0 to t. As we know that integration of 1 by x dx equal to log x, we use this formula here, log v and lower limit 0 to v equal to minus k, k is a constant, 1 dt is equal to simple t. And here 0 to t, t, this is t. So that putting the value of v here, log v minus log in this case, this is a v0 initial velocity, log v minus log v0 is equal to minus k into t. So that log m minus log n, log m minus log n equal to log m by n. Here log v minus log v0 equal to log v by this into this. Log comes here comes e to power minus kt, and v0 in denominator comes to in product, so that v equal to v0 e to power minus kt. This is the function. This is velocity function of time, because here time is a variable. Now we know that here a equal to minus kv, and we know that acceleration is can be written as v dv by ds, so that it can be written as v dv by ds, and a equal to minus kv here, so that dv equal to v and v cancel, and dv equal to k ds here, negative sign, and this limit will be initial velocity to final velocity, so that v0 to v dv equal to displacement 0 to s minus k this, so that 1 dv is equal to simple v, limit initial velocity v0 to v equal to k is a constant, and 1 ds is equal to simple s 0 to s, so that this is equal to simple s here. Now putting v minus v0 equal to minus k s, so that v velocity equal to v0 minus k s. Here this velocity is a function of displacement here, because this is a constant, this is initial velocity, and this is the variable in this case, so that this is the velocity function of displacement here. I will like the velocity function of displacement here proved. Now like, subscribe and share my videos with your friends. Thank you.